Hey folks, this is Matt once again, and I'm gonna try to make this review short, but I always say that and I fail. If you haven't seen it yet, I did a review for Shark Knight, which was on Shark Knight 3D, which I was not a big fan of that movie. That's a film that got in the theaters, $25 million budget, and all 3D and nationwide release, and there's so many other better horror films that could have gotten that and didn't, and this film did. It just didn't deserve it. Just very stupid plot. And check out my review. Again, sorry that's 30 minutes long, but I always talk a lot. That way I give away the whole movie, you don't have to see it. But this one I wanted to talk about, since I talked about that movie, a better shark movie. Red Water, Fear Strikes Where You Least Expect It, with Lou Diamond Phillips, Christy Swanson, and Coolio. Yes, a film with Coolio is better than Shark Knight. I'm sorry. Now, Red Water, which cover is misleading because it's not a great white shark, it's actually a bull shark. But Red Water, this was a pretty decent film. I can't say it's an awesome film. It's a lost hidden gem. Go check it out. Because people, if they see it, they'd be like, man, what the hell are you talking about? This is a decent film, and after seeing Shark Knight, I like this much better. The plot behind the film is definitely a lot better than Shark Knight. The plot behind the film is you have Lou Diamond Phillips. And for those right off the bat, this is a 2003 film. It was made for cable. Not only that, it was made for TBS. Okay? Take that into notion if you ever see this film. This was a made for TBS. TBS Superstation. It was made for that channel. So, it says rated R, but honestly, it should be rated PG-13. It should be rated PG-13. And one thing I didn't mention was Shark Knight. And I'm doing this review the same night, so if you mention on my Shark Knight review, I already know it. I'm doing this the same night, so you don't have to say it there. I know that shark films don't have to be rated R because Jaws and Jaws 2 were not rated R. But Jaws and Jaws 2 did it effectively. If you can't do it effectively, then your R rating can only help you. But this film doesn't need to be, it should not be rated R. PG-13 at most, to be honest. But it was made for cable, made for TBS. But saying that is pretty decent. I put it number four on shark movies I like. Jaws, Deep Blue Sea, Jaws 2, and then this film. This film would be Red Water. Like I was saying, it has Lou Diamond Phillips. It takes place in, weirdly enough, this takes place in Louisiana. The same location as Shark Night. Weirdly enough. But basically, Lou Diamond Phillips, he's a guy who used to be this oil worker, and one thing led to another, and some men got killed when there was a little ex an explosion. He blamed himself, even though it wasn't his fault, so he quit, and he's living a small, easy life with his boat, and he has a buddy. And one day, his ex-wife, Christy Swanson, I think his ex-wife, ex-girlfriend or ex-wife, comes around, Christy Swanson, and she is with this guy. They had this little, they're making like a little oil rig among the Louisiana swamp, and they want to get some like petroleum or fossil fuel petroleum, that sort of thing. And he doesn't want to accept it first because he's a little bit stubborn, but ultimately realizes he needs the money, so he accepts. And at the same time, there is a bull shark. Now, a bull shark. It was interesting that they used a different shark. It's not just a gray white, typical gray white. Just bull sharks, I think they're one of those that can go through fresh water. I believe so. I'm not that knowledgeable on sharks. Long story short, the shark starts grabbing people one by one while Lou Diamond Phillips, Christy Swanson are going to this kind of like an oil rig to help out. At the same time, you have these set of bad guys. You have Coolio, and you have this guy who expert in diving. They have gone there because, someone they knew dumped some money while he was on the run from the cops, and they grab the guy and they want to find the money, and it's in the general area. It's a money in a metal, I don't say deposit box, but it's just a metal case that's, you know, buried deep in the water. And right off the bat, I will say, the problem with the film, it is, especially the first half, a little too slow paced. Whether it's because it was a low budget made for TBS film, the shark seems like it's more in the background than it should have been. There's not that many shark attacks. So if I could say, it would have been nice if this wasn't made for cable, made for TBS. If this was just a movie that, you know, they put a little bit more money into it so that the shark did more damage, up a little bit of the gore factor. Just, again, there's no reason this says rated R, or PG-13 at most. If they add more shark action, it'd be a better movie. But the second half of the film definitely helps, and again, there's a portion in the middle that, you know, you're kind of too far away from the shark action, because what happens is, of course, Julio and the guy they get and the guy who's into diving, expert in diving, they take Lou Diamondfield's Chrissy Swanson and them hostage. You have a little bit back and forth in there. And it's about, you get some shark attacks, but again, it's made for TBS. You don't see a lot. You see, again, I know it happened with Jaws, but Jaws and even Jaws 2 did that, you know, better. So people get dragged to the ground, and like you have a grandfather who's with his grandson, and he just pulled into the water, and you have this girl just pulled into the water as well. You have this other girl who's walking across a bridge. It's one of those bridges that goes like this. So a girl is walking, and a shark comes grab her during the bridge. Didn't look as shitty as it did in Shark Night, to be honest. But I guess it didn't bother me because the plot wasn't so stupid like it was in Shark Night that blew my brains out. If you want to know what I mean, check out that review. What helps with the film is I like Lou Diamond Phillips, and he played a very good character in this film. I really liked him. I liked his character. Felt sorry for him. Chrissy Swanson, at first I'm like, oh great, another blonde chick or another chick trying to be a scientist or whatever the hell. Like, World Is Not Enough and Alone in the Dark. But Chrissy Swanson handled herself well. Coolio is Coolio. Coolio is not really the best actor, really. But at least the shark bites his head off. Although it's not gory, which that would have been nice to see. But you get the idea that he got his head bit off. So at least you got that going for it. But the second half of the film especially, it's very nice because the location looks nice. It's not that long of a film. It's 80 to 90 minutes. Basically, the oil rig, I guess they have a certain amount of pressure, and since they've been taken hostage, like, we gotta do this or it's gonna blow. And you get some practical explosions going on. And the shark is actually really well done. I read somewhere that apparently it's the first free-moving animatronic shark. And you do get little bits of CGI, but a lot of parts with the shark. And granted, there was some animatronic sharks in this, a little bit. But this, it seemed like there was more of the animatronic shark, and it looked really good, in my opinion. You get little bits of CGI, but thankfully they do them actually quickly. But you have some good animatronic sharks. You know, there's a moment where Lou Diamondfield's under and he has the scuba gear, and the shark comes and grabs the scuba tank and is dragging him along, and he has to try to escape. And especially the last 20-30 minutes, it had some fun times, I thought. Some nice practical explosions, some close calls with the shark, like the asshole. Or I should say the bad guy who knows how to dive. The bull shark's trying to get him. Like, there's a car that's sunk in the lake. And the shark's busting in, taking down off the door and going back and forth. And the way they get the shark at the end is very cool. Because it's not your typical explosion. It was very creative and it's practical, which I liked. It's an oil rig, so you got a big-ass drill. And Lou Diamond Phillips lures and tells a friend of his, you know, when I say drop the drill, and he gets his legs in the water, and when the shark pops up, he says, now, and the drill goes down, right down the fucking bull shark's throat. And like goes right into the shark's throat and drills the shit out of it. All practical. I'm like, wow, this is a made for TBS movie. And they were able to accomplish that. So that I liked as well. Doesn't leave room for a sequel. Like Piranha 3D and even this film, it ends with a shock. That's not shocking enough. Something popping up. This doesn't do that. It just, it ends and it ends. But I'm sure some people will see this film and not be a big fan of it. And I can understand why. Because this film, its fault is it's too slow moving and not enough shark. Which, you know, it's a shark, killer shark movie. There should be. But this had a bunch and it was a piece of shit. But granted, but the second half of the film is definitely much better than the first half. But at the end of the day, I'm like, okay, it was made for cable, let alone made for TBS. There wasn't bunches and bunches of CGI in my face that took me out of the movie and made it annoying. The plot I could deal with. It wasn't insanely stupid like certain movies or like Shark Attack 3. I like Lou Diamond Phillips. I like Christy Swanson. I'm like the guy who played Lou Diamond Phillips' buddy. I'm not sure what his exact name was. When the shark did appear, a lot of times it was practical. It looked good. Granted, you don't get much. You don't really get any gore or titties. But neither did Jaws or Jaws 2. Now, granted, Jaws and Jaws 2 are much better. But, I don't know, I like this movie. It was a pretty decent flick. First half, maybe too slow for people. I can understand that. But the second half, you know, you get some good, you know, firefight between Lou Diamond Phillips and Coolio and, things exploding in practical glory and close calls with the shark and it's a fun time waster. It's a decent time waster. You know, I think most people say and go, oh, it's average. Which actually is a compliment because most shark killer shark movies are abysmal and terrible and shitty. But, you know, not relying so much on CGI, having some good practical work with the shark in there, the people I cared about, like I really like dudes. That's the thing, Shark Night, there wasn't really anyone I gave humongous shit about. There was one guy, the guy who played Malik the Black Guy, and they didn't give him enough to do, and he dies. But this, you know, I really like Lou Diamond Phillips. I'm a big fan of Lou Diamond Phillips. I think that helps, too, being a big Lou Diamond Phillips fan. And, you know, if you see this film, keep with it until the second half. And if you don't like it, that's cool. But I think this is, I think if you're a fan of Lou Diamond Phillips or Christy Swanson, check it out. If you like shark, killer shark films, check it out. I will warn you that the shark is more in the background than maybe it should have been. They put a little bit more, too much emphasis on the whole hostage, Coolio and these two other guys taking Lou Diamond Phillips and them hostage while they're on the oil rig. But at the end of the day, I still had a decent time. It was a decent time waster. And I can see myself watching this again. I'm glad I have this in my collection. The second half alone, I think, is worth it. It's not too long. I think part of me gives it leniency because it was made for TBS. You know, it was made for TBS. So I give a little bit of leniency to it. Shark Night, this is a film by a guy who did R-rated films like Final Destination 2 and it went to theaters and mainstream. They had $25 million and they came up with that shit. This film, I guarantee you, it did not have $25 million. And like, so I gave it leniency on that as well. But this definitely has more going for it. with the acting, characters. Lou Diamond Phillips, Chris Swanson alone. Nice use of the practical shark, of the bull shark. A nice way of killing the shark at the end. It's different. It's practical. It's not just a typical, okay, it exploded again. Like most films, it explodes in some way, shape, or form. But yeah, it's worth your time. Definitely a decent time waster. One of the better shark films I've seen. Killer shark films I've seen. Would like to see more shark attacks. This R rating is not truthful in my opinion. It's PG-13, it's not R, but has a lot going for it in my opinion. So that's just my opinion on Redwater. Either way, thanks for watching. And again, if you don't like the film, I can understand for its slow pace. But I think the second half and LDP for life. And I think it's a lot better than this film, at least. I don't care if it's straight. I'd fucking shove it up someone's ass. But thanks for watching and take care. Later.